Hello, Church of the Red Door family. Greg Solis here. I live here in La Quinta, California, married to my beautiful wife, Monica. I have three precious children, Jack, who's 21 at Cal Baptist University, Nicole, who's 18, that's at the University of Hawaii, and Emily, who's a sophomore in high school, and still living at home. So I got one left at home. Of course, we're dealing with this pandemic and dealing with the virtual stuff, but all things considered, we're doing just great. Today, I want to share with you something that really, really is close to my heart. I've been giving a lot of thought to this, and this is, to me, a game changer in life. Having three children and raising them up in this world that we're in, you want so badly for them to just have this unquenchable love for Jesus Christ that shows itself in this passion for others. And that really is my number one goal for, you know, not only my family, but for the body of Christ in general. But outside of that, if someone were to ask me, well, Greg, what one thing would you love to bestow upon your children that they would have, that would become part of their DNA? And it really comes down to gratitude. It comes down to understanding what Jesus did on the cross for us. And starting there with an attitude of, so, Lord, what shall I do? I am so grateful. I see the blessings in my life. I see what you've done. Even in the midst of challenges, I can see your hand in it all. And that there's this attitude of gratitude that just kind of comes out of you everywhere you go. And so that takes me to 1 Thessalonians 5:18, where it says, Paul says, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. In other words, that there is just constantly this sense of gratitude that no matter what happens, no matter what the circumstances, we are able to stay positive. And I tell my kids frequently, we want to have an attitude of gratitude, and we need to keep an upbeat, positive attitude no matter what the circumstances are. So we need to get our eyes on Jesus and off the craziness. And that's sometimes really hard to do. But Paul said it well also in Philippians 4:8, where he says, finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable. If anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. I think that's a very extraordinary charge to us to say, keep your eyes focused on Jesus, look around you and see what's good. There are good things in this world that we need to stay focused on. We find ourselves getting what I call stinking thinking and getting kind of negative, and it seems like we're constantly complaining. You might want to do a double check and take a look and say, Lord, what am I doing? And I'll end with a story. This last month, we took our daughter to University of Hawaii, and in the midst of this pandemic, we were unable to actually fly with her to Hawaii. And so it was very, very difficult because we had to literally leave her at the airport, and I bawled my eyes out. It was horrible dropping your little girl off to go 2,700 miles away in the middle of the ocean on an island. It's not easy. I've never gone more than 10 days without seeing my children. Well, here it's, as I speak today, it's going to be 30 days since I've seen her, and I miss her terribly. And I was driving alone the other day, and I was listening. I have a song list that I created, where it's got all the going, it's called the Nicole Going Away List. And it's got some great worship songs, and it's got songs that we grew up on when they were little children. And I was listening to it, and I'm bawling my eyes out, thinking about everything that had taken place over these last 18 years. But I gotta say this, what the Lord had showed me, which was so amazing, is that it's a real sense of gratitude. I literally found myself in a place of worship, crying my eyes out to the Lord, thanking him for what he allowed me to do with Nicole for those 18 years. And so there was this deep, deep sense of gratitude of seeing his blessing in my life. And it could be anything. It could be, there's so many different things that we could do that. But if we take the time to think about what God has done and the blessings and focus on the positives, that will help us have an attitude of gratitude. I'll end by saying this. Chuck Swindoll said this, and I love this. He said, I'm convinced that 10% of our life is the circumstances that happens to us, and 90% is how we respond to it. And so it is with that. We have control of how are we going to, what's the frame of mind? Are we going to be able to hold our thoughts captive to the obedience of Christ? And are we going to be able to stay positive and focus on the good things in life? And are we going to look at what Christ did on the cross and walk away with a positive, upbeat attitude of gratitude? For me, that's my intention every single day. We could do that. I believe it's a game changer. I really do, especially with the crazy world we're living in right now. So with that, I pray you have an attitude of gratitude and can focus on some positive things because God is good. Take care. I hope to see you real soon. God bless.